Steve Dotto here. Today I want to talk about task automation. This is a class of service that I'm really excited about. Task automation is just basically a simple script that we create that runs, that performs a repeating task for us. Now, we've had them for a long time on our computer where we could actually write scripts that do repeating processes for us. That was for real geeks. We also have task automation in a lot of our applications. For example, in our email application, if you have a filter set up that when an email comes in from a certain person to color code it or to move it into a folder, that is a task automation process. The email comes in, the email software recognizes that it's from this person, and they change the color to blue so you can identify it. See, in the past, what you would have done is you would have highlighted that email and then turned it to blue yourself or moved it into the folder. The task automation takes that over. But most task automation that we have is limited to the application that we're running in. These new automation services will allow one application to create an action that's then reflected in another application and acted upon by that second application. So it becomes far more valuable to us by extending its reach. Now, there's two sites that I want to show you today and talk about. The first is still in beta. It's called IFTTT, which stands for if this, then that, which is really the process that we go through. If this happens, then I want that to happen. And they've got a series of things called triggers and responses. So if a trigger happens, if this trigger happens, then I want this response in an entirely different application. It's really profound. It's really very effective. The other app, now, IFTTT is really, I get a feel that it's really designed for personal use. It's really all, it's got that feel of being very personal. The other one, and there are many others out there that do this sort of service, is called Zapier. And Zapier, I feel, is a little more corporate. It's got a few more hooks into accounting software and that sort of stuff. And it's also got a little bit of a slightly different structure to their website. I like their website for this reason, is they really explain the process very easily just by interacting with the website. Let me show you what I mean. If I move my mouse over top of, say, the Gmail app here, it shows me right away what the available triggers are. Remember, I have triggers and then actions, or triggers and responses. So if I have a new email or a new thread is created, then this action can occur in another app. And as we go through all of these different apps that they have, we can see the different triggers or actions. So the trigger is the front side. The trigger is what creates an action in another app, and the available action is what it can do when a different app creates a trigger. So as we go through it, we can see all of these different triggers and actions that are available to us. Now, Zapier is a paid service. It costs about, it's a typical Web 2.0 program that costs, I think, about $100 a year to use. And they've got all of these different triggers or relationships with these different applications. So you can see that there's a wide variety. Now, if you want to just dip your toe in the water, they do have a 14-day free trial, so you can certainly try that on Zapier. But if this, then that, while it's still in beta, it's still free. I don't know what their premium service is going to charge ultimately, and as I say, it feels like it's a little bit more designed for personal use. Now, they call their scripts recipes, and I'm going to walk through the process of creating a recipe. So I've just started with it, started playing with it, got a feel for it, so I'm going to show you how I created my first recipe. So what you do is you click and you say, create a recipe. Now, the recipe that I wanted to create is to help me find a new computer. So I start by going, if this, I just click on the big this, it's hard to miss. Click on this, and then it shows me my different trigger channels. There's 7 pages of these trigger channels. So if something happens in one of these apps, it's gonna be reflected in another app. So I use Craigslist to shop a lot, and I need to find a new MacBook Pro. I'm looking for a new 13-inch MacBook Pro, but I want a fairly new model. I want one with the i7 processor. So I can go to Craigslist on a regular basis and type in a search, but I'm gonna see if I can create a IFTTT script or recipe that will do that for me. So I click on Craigslist, and it tells me right away what options I have to create a trigger. And for, as far as Craigslist is concerned, there's not a lot of options. All it is a search from the URL. So it tells me that I have to go into Craigslist, which I've got right here. I have to do the search for the MacBook Pro. I'm gonna enter that search. When I do that search, up it comes. I need to copy this text string that's created, which is basically the search criteria that Craigslist has created to find this MacBook Pro. Now, when I go back into if this, then that, then I then post that search criteria into the window here, and that creates the trigger. Now, I've created a trigger. So if this happens, then what? So here are my options of things to happen. I can send it to Evernote. I can send it to Facebook. I'm going to send it to my Gmail account. Now, this application needs permission to talk to your other application. So the first time that I clicked on Gmail, it says, do I have permission to use Gmail? And I had to give it permission. Once it was given permission, then it then creates this action, which is send an email. That's exactly what I want to do. I want to send an email. And now then it gives me the rest of the criteria. Who is it going to be sent to? I can put in my name, what information is going to be included. And in this drop-down window here, I can just include the URL. I can include just the title, or I can include the whole post. If I put in the post, we can see all of the different content that's going to appear in the email that's sent to me. So then I create this recipe, and then I enact the recipe. And if I head back into the, let's see if I can go back into the homepage here. I'm going to leave this page because I've already created this recipe. I don't want to do it twice. You can see that I have this recipe now, and it's turned on and ready to run. So if I click on my personal recipes, I can see that I have a Craigslist MacBook Pro search, which is why I named it. If something happens in Craigslist, then a Gmail response is what is created. This is a really compelling class of software. Where it goes, who knows? I mean, I look at some very, very simple processes that I can think of right off the top of my head. But if you go into here, into the browse area, you can see all of the a lot of filters that people have saved, and to give you ideas of, sorry, not filters, different recipes that people have created. And if you go through, there are probably hundreds of different recipes that people have created. Some of the interesting ones that I saw is people have created ones that says, send the weather to my calendar every day. I thought, why would you want to do that? And then I realized, well, you know, if you're a journaler, I don't remember what the weather was like last Wednesday, but if it was sent to my calendar, just a little rainy, this temperature, that might be something that I'm interested in having, especially if I'm a journaler or a blogger in keeping track of, you know, what the weather is like in my neighborhood. So all of these little simple processes, they've got 2,000 pages worth of these processes that you can browse through. I don't recommend you go through them all, but as you start to play with this software, it's sure worthwhile to spend a little bit of time roving through it to see the ideas that other people have for task automation. I hope that you found this video to be useful. If you have, please give us some props. Give us a like. I do appreciate that. Don't forget, you can subscribe to all our Dotto Tech videos. We appreciate the time you spend with us. Have a good day. I am Steve Dotto.